Good morning, 11th class. In earlier video, we have learned about limiting reagent and how to identify which one is limiting reagent or which one is excess reagent. Now, numericals related to limiting reagent. Now, in this one, okay, I'll explain two questions to you. Okay, now, first one is, now check, it's a 50 kg of N2 and 10 kg of H2, it's a nitrogen and hydrogen, both exist as a diatomic molecule, are mixed to produce NH3, it's a ammonia. Calculate your first question in this one, first part is calculate the ammonia formed, identify the limiting reagent in this reaction. Okay, now first of all, you have in this one when you have to calculate limiting reagent, so your first work is you have to write their equation. Okay, now just see, as we know, equation is basically a Haber's process. This one is normally when nitrogen, just see, nitrogen react with hydrogen, then it gives NH3. You have to balance it. Okay, now it, this one is 3, this one is 2. It means 1 mole of nitrogen react with 3 mole of hydrogen to give 2 moles of ammonia. This one is a general reaction. You know this one, it means nitrogen and hydrogen, it required in which ratio? That one is 1:3. Okay, and then it gives 2 moles of NH3. Now you have to, this one is normal by equation, your ratio is given to you. Now actually, how many moles are present, that you have to calculate. So first of all, calculate number of moles for hydrogen and nitrogen, then we'll solve question also. Again, now just see, moles of nitrogen, simple, given mass upon molar mass, because here molecule is given, the given mass upon molar mass, or otherwise mass in gram upon molar mass, it's the same thing. Okay, that one is given, mass in gram upon molar mass. Now just check, mass is given 50 kg, but here it's a mass in gram, so you have to convert it into gram. Now multiply by 1000, and molar mass, nitrogen is 14 into 2, it's a 28. After solving this, your answer is 1.786 into 10^3 mole. Okay, this one is actual mole of nitrogen which is reacting, because here condition is given to you, 50 kg or this one, you have to calculate number of moles according to given weight. Now second is way moles of, this one is hydrogen, same, mass in gram upon molar mass, the mass in gram, it's a 10 kg converted into gram, converted, multiply by 1000, divided by 2, because hydrogen atomic mass is 1 into 2, then it's 2. Okay, cancel it, this one is 5 into 10^3 mole. Now this one is moles according to question. Now just see, as I told you, N2 plus 3H2, it gives 2NH3. It means 1 mole of nitrogen react with 3 moles of hydrogen. Now just see, according to the equation, 1 mole of nitrogen required 3 moles of hydrogen. Okay, it means, okay, what's the actual weight of nitrogen? It's a 1.786 into 10^3 mole. This one is for 1 mole. Now just see, 1.786 into 10^3 mole of nitrogen will require hydrogen. Kitne chahiye? 1:3 ratio. Okay, it means 3. This number is multiplied by 3. So 3 into 1.786 into 10^3. Okay, it means 5.36 into 10^3 mole. Okay, it means, okay, that is to react with nitrogen. And how much nitrogen? That is 1.786 into 10^3. Okay, this much of hydrogen is required. But now check, our moles of hydrogen is only 5 into 10^3. It means this one is less. Okay, just check. But moles of hydrogen present is itna, but how much is required? It's a 5.36. It shows what? That one is nitrogen is present in excess, and hydrogen is, this one is, just see, that one is, okay, now check in this one, but moles of hydrogen present is 5 into 10^3 moles. Now nitrogen is in excess because it's a more, okay, as comparison to hydrogen. So hydrogen is a limiting reagent because it's a 0.36, it's less. Okay, so that one, hydrogen is limiting reagent. Okay, so then you have to calculate how much ammonia is formed. So now just see, 3 moles of hydrogen gives how many, this one, ammonia, it's a 2 moles. So 3 moles of hydrogen gives NH3, it's a 2 mole. So what about 5 into 10 is to power 3 moles of hydrogen? Why I am writing 5 into 10 is to power 3 mole? Because hydrogen is present in this amount only. Okay, so only 5 into 10 is to power 3 moles of hydrogen will react with nitrogen. So how much ammonia is formed? It's a 2 upon 3. It's a unitary method. 3 goes down. 5 into 10 is to power 3 goes up. After solving this, your answer is, because this one become 10. Okay, and 10 divided by 3, it's a 3.3333. So you can write 3.3 into 10 is to power 3 moles. Now convert this into mass. Now just see. Mass of NH3 formed. Okay, formula is moles into molar mass, because number of moles is equal to given mass upon molar mass. So molar mass goes that side, and answer is 3.3 into 10 to the power 3 into 17, because ammonia, molar mass of ammonia is 17, because it's a 14 plus 1 into 3, the total is 17. After multiplying this, your answer is, now this one is 56.1, this one is 56.1 into 10 is to power 3 gram. Convert it into kg, so your answer is 56.1 kg. Okay, done. Now this one is one numerical. Now second is, now check, it's almost same. If 20 gram of calcium carbonate is treated with 20 gram of HCl, how many grams of CO2 can be produced according to the reaction? Now just see, in this reaction is also given to you. Okay, and only condition is given ki 20 gram of calcium carbonate is treated with 20 gram of HCl, how many gram of CO2 can be produced? It means your main concern is with CO2. Now check your reaction. Now just see, this one is a reaction. First of all, you have to write reaction. It's done. So 1 mole of calcium carbonate react with 2 moles of HCl, and then it gives 1 mole of CO2. So first of all, just see, 1 mole and 2 mole, you have to calculate their molar mass. Okay, now this one is 40 plus 12 plus 16 into 3, it's 100. After calculating this, it's a 73 gram. Actually, this one is calculated, this one becomes 70 plus 1, this one is 71 plus 2, it becomes 73 gram. Now just see above equation, if you will see, the 100 gram of calcium carbonate requires 73 gram of HCl, because 1 mole, okay, ratio is 1 is to 2, and here gram is 100 gram requires 73 gram. Why I am calculating in gram? Because here you have to calculate how many gram of CO2 are produced. Okay, that's why. So 100 gram of CaCO3 requires 73 gram of HCl. So what about 20 gram of CaCO3 requires? The unitary method, 100 goes down, 20 goes up. Your answer is 14.6 gram. But now check in this one. Okay, that one is CaS, this one is, but check, what's the actual percentage of HCl? HCl is, sorry, what's the actual gram of HCl? HCl is 20 gram, and only how much is required? 14.6. It means HCl is actually present in excess. Okay, so CaCO3 is a limiting reagent and HCl is excess reagent. So now just see, in this one, CaCO3 plus 2HCl, it gives CaCl2 plus H2O plus CO2. So 1 mole of CaCO3, it gives, along with HCl, it gives 1 mole of CO2. Okay, but now our comparison is with limiting reagent, because CaCO3 limits the reaction. So we'll calculate their gram with limiting reagent. So 100 gram, okay, 100 gram of CaCO3, and what's the molar mass of CO2? It's a 44 gram. So what about 20 gram? Okay, when 20 gram react, then how much CO2 is produced? So now again, same, it's a unitary method. 100 gram of CaCO3 produce 44 gram of CO2. So what about 20 gram? It's a 44 upon 100, 20 goes up. So calculate it. It's a, with this. Okay, after calculating this, your answer is 8.80 gram. Okay, thank you.